Hello?
Hey, Vinny, how are you?
Is this Dr. Townsend?
This is he, how are you?
I don't want to hear from you anymore, dude. I'm done with
you.
Well,
can you give me a few minutes, please? Please?
Okay.
All right. So, I understand that you want to go back to Community Reach Center. And your message to me was that they didn't do anything, but at least they didn't force drugs down your veins, right?
Right.
Okay. So, let me just look at something real quick. I am very understanding of your weight gain and not wanting to be controlled by medicines and all of that stuff.
No, I'm fine with medicine. I would like medicine, but I don't need medicine that's making me gain over 100 pounds in a month. I've already become pre-diabetic on your guys' medications, and I can't do that again.
That's too much, and I agree. I'm just trying to look at the last time that you met Dr. Goyer, and it looks like it's been a while.
Yeah, this past year and a half, you guys have been torturing me, and you almost killed me.
Okay. So you and I have had many good conversations, and a lot of them have been based on, you know, sort of mutual respect and mutual understanding. And so I'm asking if you would just give it a shot to talk to Dr. Goya and talk about the side effects that you've had, especially the weight gain. And have you had lethargy as well or no?
Huh?
Have you had, like, lack of motivation, anything like that?
I get body aches and stuff when I wake up. Okay. I'm really tired. I'm just sleeping all the time, man. It's
okay.
Ridiculous.
Yeah, and those are the two biggest side effects of the medicines are weight gain and hypersomnia.
And my mom said that Latuda was given to me by Dr. Fisher when he was working with you guys.
Okay.
And she said that Latuda would probably be better. She said.
Okay.
I don't really remember it, but she said that I didn't gain as much weight on Latuda.
And do you trust that? Do you trust that she says that? Do you trust what she's saying?
I don't know. She's kind of a lunatic too, but.
You know, that's what parents are supposed to be—is lunatics, I think.
Yeah, she's a little bit different.
So, I'm going to. Is it okay if while you and I are on the phone that I type an email to Dr. Goya?
Well, I'm going back to Community Reach Center.
Well, what I'm asking is that we just, you know, give this a shot, Vinny.
I did. I've given you guys a year and a half, and you guys have put me through the worst times of my life. On top of COVID.
You haven't seen Dr. Goya, though.
I have seen Dr. Goya. She laughs in my face when I talk to her about this stuff.
I know Dr. Goya. She's not a laugh-in-your-face kind of person.
Well, she had her mask on, so it could have just been a giggle.
Okay.
Dr. Townsend, why am I on this certification?
I told you before, Vinny. I mean, it's like...
I'm gravely disabled?
This is the kind of, like, the thing that doesn't really... that people don't understand is... And I think I explained grave disability to you. It's like that people, when their mental illness is bad, that they can't take care of themselves as much as they usually can when it's not...
How am I not taking care of myself?
Well, you've been in the hospital a lot, my friend.
Yeah, because Emily from All Health Network is literally right across the street with the Englewood Police Department. And they come over to my house every other week, harassing me. They don't even talk to me anymore. They just immediately just take me to the mental hospital now.
Vinny, is that the TV in the background?
Oh, yeah, I could pause that.
Yeah, can you do that? Or just, like, mute it?
Yeah, so... Yeah, and they've been harassing me every other week for the past year and a half. They don't even talk to me anymore. They just immediately take me to the mental hospital.
If I said to you, hey, Vinny, guess what? You're now in charge of all of your treatment. What would you do differently?
Go back to Community Reach Center where they don't do this crazy stuff to me.
I'm sorry, go back to Community Reach Center?
Yeah.
But your message was that they're not doing anything for you.
I gave them a couple of months and stuff, but they're better than you guys.
Okay.
Because they're not trying to kill me.
So, So what will happen is if you decide to do that, I'm not going to say don't do that. Two things. You'd probably have to move because you're not in your catchment area.
Yeah, and I'm going to do that because I don't want to live across this police department anymore.
And the second thing, which is what you'll probably like, is that they won't accept my transfer certification, so you'll be voluntary again.
And there's no reason for me to be on a certification anyway, and I've proven that to you many a time.
So, let me see something. Have you been in contact with them at all?
Yeah.
Like recently?
Yeah.
And did you express your desire to like rejoin them?
Yeah.
And what did they say?
Yeah, I'm already becoming a part of Community Reach Center already. And I didn't tell you on purpose because I didn't want you to mess it up.
No, that's fine. No, I'm not going to mess it up. Did you have an appointment with them yet? I mean, do you have an appointment scheduled?
Yeah.
When is that?
Well, I don't really want to tell you because I don't want you to mess it up.
And you don't have to tell me. Would you like me to be a part of that or no?
No, definitely not.
Okay. So what I would ask is that once you schedule that and they accept you, that you have somebody call me and say that you're going to be going there?
Yeah, I'll have one of them call you.
Is that fair?
Yeah, I'll have one of them call you.
Okay.
And
so I just want to remind you that...
Little word of advice, Dr. Townsend, maybe not be all scary and stuff, because you scared the shit out of him last time you talked to him.
I scared them?
Yeah. They looked at me and they said, they looked at me and they said, I don't know why he's doing this to you, Vinny.
Oh, I would have nothing scary to say about you. So,
well, I've been trying to get treatment for the past year and a half. I seriously need a therapist. I've been dealing with my suppressed memories, and I've been having flashbacks and nightmare flashbacks.
Okay.
And I've been dealing with all this stuff on my own while you keep putting me on a cert and shoving pills down my throat.
Okay. And when you were with them, they didn't give you medicine?
No.
Okay. But I want to remind you that you got you got sicker. And you ended up hospitalized, and then you ended up with MHCD.
And yeah, so that I know. I was there. And there's nothing wrong with me.
Okay, I'm not.
There's something wrong with you, but there's nothing wrong with me.
I'm not denying there's something wrong with me. But I also don't want to deny that when you and I have a chance, we communicate pretty well. So go ahead and set that up and then have somebody contact me. And if you want to be, just so you trust that, if you want to be a part of that conversation, that's fine.
Well, it'd be a lot easier for me to trust you if you'd take this baloney certification off of me.
Well, if you engage with them, I'm pretty sure that they won't...
Yeah, because they're not crazy.
They won't take the certification, so...
I know that. That's why I'm going there.
Okay.
So I can actually get recovery and treatment instead of being tortured and almost killed.
Okay.
And I would appreciate it if you could talk to your All Health representative, Emily, at the police department over here and tell her to leave me alone, too. Because I'm trying to live my life. I'm trying to salvage what little life I have left with most of my family dead and two dead girlfriends. And my molestation and my gang date rape and my almost human trafficking and the police harassing me, it all needs to stop. And I need to get back to my life because this All Health certification forcefully injecting me and forcefully dumping pills down my throat isn't helping me. This is making my life a misery.
Okay. So can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Would you consider this a good conversation between you and I?
Not really.
No? Oh,
we haven't gotten anywhere, dude. We're still at ground zero.
I've heard you out, and I know what you want. And we're going to pursue the referral to CRC, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So you've got my number. Call me anytime you want. And my preference, just so you trust the process, is after you have your session with CRC, is that you and a contact person at CRC and me just have like a really quick conference call, okay?